Hey guys, it's Erin. How are you? I have not filmed something for you for a little bit just because life has been a little bit crazy growing this kid and just logistics. So I've been using my husband as my model and the other people for the workouts. But today, 19 plus weeks, I am starting something that I was hoping to work on a bigger level, the pre-pregnancy part, right? I'm doing post-pregnancy. So the pre-pregnancy part is I'm going to be doing a video every week, little pre-pregnancy workouts. If you can't use them, for your friends to use them, but this is going to be under the hashtag pregnant jock on Twitter, on the digdeepplayhard.com blog, on the facebook.com digdeepplayhard page. So it's once a week the pregnant jock videos will be out there. This one today is a fun little one. You can do it after doing cardio for those prenatal mamas. Of course, before anything, make sure for a time, make sure to please get the approval from your doctor that it is okay, and that you've got the approval to exercise. And always consult your body the entire time, listening to where you're at. Take it down, step it up, do what you feel comfortable with. Work with the Borg scale, which is a rate of perceived exertion. And the easiest way I would say with that one is go between number 1 and number 10 and try and stay between 6 and a 7 when you're pregnant. Sometimes you go above that, of course, if your body's used to it, hence pregnant jocks. But if not, just stick between a 6 and a 7 and maintain that comfort zone right there. Okay, so what you're going to need today for the little workout is to do some cardio before. You can do some fast walk, you can do a jog, you can do cycling, whatever it is, for about 30 minutes. Get that cardio part in. And then you're going to want a nice exercise band right here. So once it goes around your ankle, a jump rope, and a set of weights. Okay, the weights can be light weights for you, which might be 5 pounds or 8 pounds, 3 pounds, 4 pounds, whatever it is. But that's all that you're going to need. So we're going to do some sidestepping first to get into your hips and your inner and outer thigh, which like to shift when you're pregnant. So of course, a lovely extra love, I call it, the extra adipose tissue that likes to add on right here, your lower back, your arms, when you're growing a kid up here. Kind of fun how it works, isn't it? So you're going to roll your shoulders back, tuck that fanny under, engage your core. Yes, you do have a core when you're pregnant. Shoulders back and down. So you're going to sidestep, okay? So you're going to try and go 10 to one side, 10 to the other. The whole while keeping your knees facing forward, bum tucked under, core nice and engaged. Okay? So you're going to sidestep 10 to one side, 10 to the other. Try and do 30 reps. If you think 30 is too much, do 10, 15, 20. Do that magic number for you. Then you're going to grab your weights. You're going to roll your shoulders back. Posture is very important, especially when pregnant. And because you'd like to hunch forward as you're getting fatigued, as your core is taking over. A nice little baby bump, going like that. So shoulders back, arms up. Roll those shoulders back. Now you can go to a reverse lunge with the alternate kick. Reverse lunge, alternate kick. Reverse and alternate. You're able to engage your core as you're doing so, strengthening your legs, keeping that hip nice and tucked under. So arms back, way back, tuck that hip under, come down, shift. And shift. Roll your shoulders back. From here, go right to some nice lat raises. Front, mid, inside. Front, mid, inside. Front, mid. Shoulders back and down. Inside. From here, you're going to take your weights. Go right to some tricep presses. Roll your shoulders back. Your back is nice and flat. Just press back. Press. Try and do again 10 to 15 reps. And then next one, you're just going to press back, squeeze your hands together. So you press, squeeze. Yes, you got a shot at my vibrator. Kind of fun. Not really. There you go. Press, squeeze. Press, squeeze. Press, and squeeze. Then from there, you're going to take your jump rope. You don't have a jump rope, just pretend. And you're just going to jump right under the couch. If the heart rate's too much, go to 15, 20. Work that magic number. That's too much for you. Jumping rope, if it seems too much on your pelvic floor, just do 1 foot, okay, and then do the other. But it's all you can do. I got my workout earlier, hence I'm still pretty warm in here, sweating a bunch. But that's what I want you to do for this first workout. This is week one of Pregnant Jock series, and I'm going to try and go all the way until this baby bean is born, which will be January 3rd. I hope. Okay. Take care. Have a great one. Any questions, feel free to email me or contact me at digdeepplayhard.com, facebook.com/digdeepplayhard. Twitter is at Power Fitness. Take care. Bye.